Hi, this is Dr. Mike Ryan answering the question, what is the difference between compression stockings, compression support hose, and TED stockings? Well, there are some distinctions, and the primary distinction is the amount of compression that's in the stocking. Compression stockings themselves are usually have a compression strength greater than 20 millimeters of mercury. And that increases to 30 millimeters of mercury at the ankles. It's called graduated because it's less higher up and greater compression at the ankle. And that pressure forces or helps force the circulation up the leg. Support hose are less than that. And often compression stockings do require a prescription. You can get them online without a prescription, but often a medical provider will give you a prescription that you can get. And then TED stockings are also a brand of support hose that does not require a prescription. And their strength is 16 to 20. So 16 millimeters at the calf and 20 millimeters at the ankle. And the less the compression strength, the easier it is that you can put them on. And the more likely people will wear them all day because they're easy to manage. Often the lighter weight ones often will not last as long as the heavier strength because the thickness of the fabric is less. And for different conditions, it's important to have greater strength. The 20-30 is the minimum that most insurance companies will require when they require a conservative stocking trial waiting period, which is the way insurance companies make sure people have complied with their requirement for a waiting period before approving treatment. Otherwise, for everyday use, support hose, TED stockings can also be very beneficial. And for some patients, actually, especially ones that have trouble getting the stockings on, the heavier strength stockings can be very difficult to put on. One trick I tell them is to buy two pair of TED stockings or two pair of support hose, and you put one pair on, and then the second one goes on very easy over it because it slides right over the material, and you get more compression that way. It's actually a very, very effective way to get more compression without having to struggle putting your stockings on. One other bit of advice to always make sure is that you're getting the correct size. A lot of the support hose do not have a lot of range in the sizing. Your prescription stockings actually generally have a little chart on the website or on the box of the stocking. And you have to measure different things, different elements, the ankle circumference, the calf circumference, and then for the knee-high stockings at least, and then those two measurements will match on a little chart, and that'll tell you what size is appropriate. If you get stockings that are too small, first of all, they're very difficult to get on, and second of all, they're very painful, and third, they can actually cause nerve damage to the sensory nerves of the skin, especially along the shin and ankle, and it's something that when that happens can take months to recover. So you want to make sure you have the right size. So patients ask me, which one should I start with? Well, in part that depends on your goals. If you want to get treatment, you want to make sure you're complying with your insurance requirements. And usually that means a 20 to 30 level compression stocking. If you're doing it simply to get some relief and support, you're not really looking to get a treatment at any time in the near future, then anything over the counter, anything online, just as long as you do some research and make sure it's the correct size is what is going to match what you're looking for. And there's a great deal of variety online of different products, and you may find that you get something and it's not quite what you're looking for. It may not be long enough, it may be too tight in the foot, etc. And you probably want to see reviews about them and be prepared that you may have to try a different product, a different vendor to get something that will be more comfortable. But for people that have vein circulation problems, vein reflux, compression stockings really make a big difference for a lot of people and allow them to go through the day without suffering. So Dr. Mike Ryan answering the question, what is the difference between compression stockings, support hose, and TED stockings?